Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Van Dilla, naturopathic physician and your host. In the studio today with me is a wonderful clairvoyant healer, manual therapist, and emotional release worker, Harbhajan Singh Khalsa. Thank you very much for coming on the show. And he has invited a guest patient, Jan, to demonstrate or he will be demonstrating on her some of the techniques that he uses. Harbhajan Singh Khalsa is a therapist here in Santa Fe, New Mexico, and also in Taos, New Mexico. So welcome to the show. And tell us, you are in dress. What is your traditional dress?
Traditionally, this is the Sikh dress. And it's we actually have, it's called the five Ks. We have a kutta, we wear white clothes, kachetas. There's a little kirpan, which is a little knife, and it has all symbolism being a Sikh, but it also has energetic symbolism as far as what we are and as far as balancing our whole being.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
So you are part of the American Sikh.
American Sikh tradition, which is part of the global Sikh tradition in worldwide.
And we are lucky that here in New Mexico, northern New Mexico, in Española, there is a center.
International community. It's the international community in the world.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. I didn't realize that. And I recently attended an event there, and it was like being in a Sikh heaven with all this, the traditional, the turban, the men with their long beards, little children running around with the top knots. It was really delightful. And there's a tradition of feeding people that come to events, and there was wonderful vegetarian food. So,
it was called the 11/11/11, November 11th, and that is the age of Aquarius.
So we are
the age of us together, we serving humanity.
Excellent. And you serve humanity by you've been trained in a number of different techniques. Mm-hmm. Plus, it sounds like you were born with certain gifts in clairvoyance.
Well, I popped out of the womb and I started seeing things that nobody else used to see, and I thought it was normal. God, this is an interesting world out here.
So clairvoyance is seeing.
Seeing, altered, seeing other dimensions, seeing beyond the eyes, and also hearing,
okay,
which is clairaudio, to hear other dimensions, and also to sensing. Okay, going beyond the senses, feeling beyond the senses. So you have an insight, especially if you're a therapist or teaching yoga, to actually feel out what's going on with your patients. Okay, so it's just an advantage. Okay, it's another witness.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, that you have in healing.
These gifts really set you up for the work you got into.
Yes, it did. I was previously some other profession, which we won't mention. I used to be a plumbing contractor. How's that? Long time ago, because my father was in that business. But I just carried on this tradition. I've been studying since the 60s. And my mother was into healing, so it was kind of in my blood. And my uncle was a osteopath, and so I just carried on this tradition. Yeah.
And you've been trained by Upledger?
I was trained by John Upledger. I personally assisted him in his classes. We worked on patients together.
Wow.
And what a gift that was.
And his tradition is what?
Tradition is craniosacral.
Okay.
And somato-emotion release. Okay?
Somato-emotion
release. And what a character that guy is.
And that means somato is body.
Somato is body.
So you're blending body and emotional
and
work.
Emotion, yes. The key person that I got most of my technology from was Jean-Pierre Barrault from Barrault Institute.
And his techniques?
He's an osteopath from France, from Grenoble, France.
An osteopath.
And he practices and taught visceral manipulation. He taught vascular manipulation, which is the blood. Okay. He taught the nervous system, how to manipulate the nerves. It's very, very interesting, very profound what it does for patients. And he also taught us how to do articular global manipulation to the joints with no popping and no thrusting.
So
just gentle movement.
This sounds more like Traeger or...
It goes way beyond that. It's going inside the body. All these technologies go inside. So when you change the configuration and the relationship to the organs, the nerves, the bones, the lymph system, the cerebrospinal fluid. You change the hormones. You change the enzyme levels. You change the mind. You change the cells. So generally, when you get a treatment from this technology, you get one treatment and you might not come back for 3 weeks. Instead of going to a chiropractor, going to someone else, and you get a treatment every week. Mm-hmm. Because it's such deep, deep, deep healing, including emotional healing. Yeah.
And what we're calling this show is Introduction to Manual Therapy and Energy Medicine. And you have a very holistic point of view that you were just describing in dealing with the whole body, the emotional body, and our spirit, which is a fantastic inclusion.
It's the mind, body, spirit. You need to treat the mind. You need to treat the spirit. And you need to treat the emotions. I had a patient tell me the other day, he said he went away to Austin, he lives in Taos, and he said his whole neck was out, mm-hmm. his back was out, and as soon as he realized his own emotional problems, the pain went away. Now, as far as spirit, yes, we're all connected, all of us. One humanity, one mind, one soul, we're all connected. And everything we say, think, or project affects us. Now, in relation to healing, you can heal with one touch, one word, or one look. That's how profound healing can be. And yes, it takes a meditative mind, it takes practice, it takes sensory-receptive receptors in your hands to feel. It takes to know how the mind works. And through Yogi Bhajan, through 3HO and Sikh Dharma.
Okay, and Yogi Bhajan.
Yogi Bhajan is my yogic master, okay. Who I study with, who I owe everything to, because he introduced me to so many different healing techniques. Satnam Rasayan, which is an energy medicine.
And he was the Sikh master.
Sikh master, yogi, healer, amazing man, genius.
And he came to this country in, what was it?
In late 1968, okay? He actually came to Canada, and then he came to this country. And he's known throughout the United States. He counseled most of the presidents from Nixon on. And also with all the governors of New Mexico. We're in the Chronicles of New Mexico.
Because Yogi Bhajan lived here in Espanola.
Lived here, yes.
For quite a while.
And he was a person that was a character, totally intelligent. He never said no to anyone. He always helped, and he taught us how to serve. And he taught us how to be yogis, practicing Kundalini Yoga. So this is all the basis for being a healer, manual therapist, teacher, that he's given me so I can, in turn, give it to other people, the technology of healing.
So in addition to actually working with individuals, you mm-hmm. also teach Kundalini
yes.
Yoga?
Teach Kundalini Yoga.
And Pilates?
Not Pilates, Kundalini. Okay. In our center, we teach Pilates. Okay. So I have compiled anywhere from between 14 and 15,000 hours of teaching Kundalini Yoga. I started in 1976. Actually, before that, with Swami Satchananda. So this is all the background of where I've been and where it's taking me to right now.
Excellent.
And I'm at the pinnacle of my life of just being being a healer, being a manual therapist, okay? But at the same time, there's so much to learn. Mm-hmm. There's so much to learn. It's very humbling. You think you know a lot. When you think you know a lot, you know a little.
Yeah,
it's true.
We were speaking earlier, and you were saying that the more you know,
the more you don't know,
the more you realize you don't know and how humbling it is.
It's funny. You can take a class. You're working on patients, and then you take a new class, and you put your hand on your patient, and it says, oh, my God, look at this, all this information.
Would you demonstrate to us what some of this actually looks like?
Well, it's more like feeling and sensing and experiencing than what it looks like.
Well, I think a lot of people, when they think of working emotionally, it's sitting and talking. But you mentioned that this patient of yours, when they were thinking about their neck pain, they had a release of both the physical pain by even thinking of it as an emotional.
Well, emotional is part of the big picture. You need to release the emotion. So what I can do with Jan Anderson, who is a professional interior designer from Santa Fe, and she came to me with cancer lymphoma. She came to me with hip problems, sciatica problems, back problems, okay? And a lot of emotional things, which we've taken a chip out of a lot of things, haven't we? Mm-hmm. Yes. Basically, you've changed your life in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. See, what happens when we get sick, we want to give up because we had it for so long. We don't know what to do. Who do we seek out? Mm-hmm. Do I take a pill from Western medicine or do I go to this doctor? Yes, that does help to get a diagnosis. So that's why we have alternative holistic medicine. It's another natural approach using physical manual therapy, herbs. You can use needles. Okay, these are all different facets of alternative medicine. And then there's the pinnacle of a person being a healer or a manual therapist. So at least with Jan, what I probably should do is have you sit up and we'll demonstrate some of these things. I think what I want to do is have her lay down.
Okay.
And I'll just show you some assessment skills that we've learned.
Right.
So if we could get up and do that, that would be great. Here we go. Here, why don't you just lay on your back? Yes. So scoot down a bit. So one of the first things we do is I put my hand on her head and I feel what's going on, okay? And right now she has tension in her skull and the tensor cerebellum, which is where the brain sits on right here, right
okay,
on top.
Wait, slow down, say yep. that. So what you have your hand underneath, mm-hmm. and you're trained in craniosacral, so you were
actually,
with
this is visceral manipulation.
Visceral yep. manipulation.
And it can also be that this is the vault used for holding craniosacral.
Okay.
And you feel the bones, you feel the fluids, and
so
with
you're
her,
sensing through
I'm
your
sensing
hands,
through my hands,
pulse,
through the sensation, I feel what's going on, and she has emotional things going on right now, okay? Because there's pressure in her skull, okay? And that pressure is causing pressure in her whole nervous system. The body can only have up to 20 pounds of pressure. And then what happens is the nervous system reacts. And how does it react? It makes these little beads or buds in the nervous system and on the surface. So there's little buds and these are a release. This is where the nerves get twisted, okay? Which interferes with the flow of the nervous system. And we're trained how to release these buds, okay, and release the nervous system. So right now, I'm going to put my hand on her head. I'm going to feel what's going on. And right now, when I feel her head, I'm pressing. And when I press, I feel the restriction. Now, how do I know what I'm feeling?
This is a very light pressure.
Very light pressure, light pressure.
You're not trying to adjust anything.
We're not trying to adjust. We're pressing on the whole system. And the bones move. And everything move. But if there's a bone that's out of place, if there's a muscle that's restricted, we feel it when we press on the head. Okay? And she has some things going on with her temporals on the right. Okay? Her right temporal is not moving. Okay? And then I feel, and I'm also putting my hand, I feel what's going on here in her in the nerves going into her ear. Okay?
So one thing is the pieces of our skull are not glued together, so there is movement. So you're sensing a very subtle movement or non-movement.
There is the relationship between the bones. There's a relation to the vascular. There's a relation to the nervous system. So we're feeling. And then you ask questions. Is this physical? Is it emotional? And if it is physical, is it bones? Is it the nervous system? Is it the nerves? Or is it the organs? And for her, it's more structural right now because she's having problems with her hip. And if I look down to her left foot, it's rotated to the left. Okay, so that's telling me something's going on with her joint on her left femur. Okay, so it's also telling me when I'm looking, so we're taught to feel, and then we're taught to look and see what's where when we push, where did it go? And this is going to her left hip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get down to that left hip. Okay, but before I do that, I need to do something here. Okay, so I'm going to put my hands like this. Now, she's been suffering from hip injury.
So your hands are interlocked.
Interlocked like this.
Right,
actually,
behind her.
Lapped like this. And so, now, this woman is a very rambunctious, energetic woman. And she loves to work and have fun. She's just selling her house, and she's going to be going to, where are you going to?
Mexico,
to Yucatan. She's moving there. And she was raking leaves all day long, and she overstressed her muscles in her back. She strained the muscles in her back. And that's on the left side, okay? So here we're going to go.
Are you tractioning?
I'm actually squeezing the mastoid bones behind the ears, okay?
Okay,
I'm squeezing them, and I'm feeling what it feels like. And there's more restriction on the left side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate, okay, her skull, head, and I'm going to feel her cerebrospinal fluid expand.
You're feeling her
cerebrospinal fluid. I'm feeling expanding.
And there's
expanding, and now I'm pressing, and I'm rotating, and feeling, and following to release, and there it goes. Okay? And it just released. This is the tantrum cerebellum and back of the brain. So release the
Say
left side.
Say that again.
The tantrum cerebellum, and this is part of the brain. Okay? This is part of the fibrous tissue that's in the brain. We have the fac cerebri here and then the tantrum cerebellum underneath. So we just released that left side. This just got really released. If you're going to release the hip, you need to release the occiput. You release the tantrum cerebellum. And also you need to release the brain stem. There's a brain stem with all the nerves going through her skull, going from inferior to superior. So we need to check this out right now. Okay?
So you're working with the physical brain.
I'm working with the physical brain right now.
The structure of the
yes.
brain as well as the
Yeah. So what I need to do is, since I release this side, the left side, I need to release the right side. Okay? So this is called articular manual manipulation. Okay?
Articular
manual manipulation. Yep. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to go to the other side and feel and wait for the time. There it goes.
So you're released. Working, the articular is the joints.
Articular is the
you're
joints.
Working with the muscles
yes.
and the joints.
So, okay. So I'm feeling it right now. And now I'm feeling tension in her neck, which is actually when you feel the tension in the neck, in the backside of the head, you know there's something going on with the hips. Because there's synchrony between the cervicals and the lumbar mm-hmm. below. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to press again. I'm going to feel, and I can feel the release, but we need to release the brainstem in there, okay? Because I feel the stiffness. It's like a tube. If you want to be really basic, it's like a tube of nerves going into the brain, okay?
From the spinal cord.
From the spinal and the spinal cord, yeah. And so what I want to do is I want to feel that right now, because what happens is if you have chronic physical problems, even emotional problems, what happens when we get emotional?
Tense up.
We tense. We get stressed. And so this causes tension to go inside our body. And this is chronic after years and years. That tension just stays in your body. These are mental, emotional patterns which are in the brain. Narrow peptide loops. Okay, we have positive loops in the brain. And then we have negative loops. And then we have these habits. And depending on our relationship to ourselves, it's depending how we relate to these habits. Some of them are subconscious, some of them are conscious, okay? So if you ever watch What the Bleep, the documentary, it tells you about these neuropeptide loops, okay? So we're dealing on a physical level, emotional level, mental level, and a spiritual level. So how does it apply for a spiritual level? Well, if you're connected to infinity, you're connected to yourself, or you're one with yourself, you have energy. And energy is moving through the body, through the meridians and through the chakras. Meridians in Chinese medicine and through the chakras in Ayurvedic. Okay? It's very complex. We have all these meridians, we have these chakras, and then we have the areas of the body. So there's so many.
The what?
The areas of the body. These are energy flows of prana, or in Chinese medicine we call it qi, okay, that follow through the body. Okay. Then what Yogi Bhajan taught us, he taught us about the 10 bodies. We actually have 10 bodies. The first body is a soul. First body is a negative mind. The third body is a positive mind, then the neutral mind, the fourth. The fifth is a physical body. Sixth is the arc line. Seventh is the aura. The eighth is the pranic body. The ninth is the subtle body. And the tenth is the radiant body. And when you're a spiritual person, you balance all those bodies. But what is traditionally in the industry is we talk about the etheric body. Because that's where everything, it's all around the body. And there's, etherically, there is a connection with, there's an etheric in the cosmos, okay? Okay? So all these interrelationships. Look, the more you know, so every time you learn something, you're learning something else.
And what you're talking about with these different bodies,
yes,
this is ancient knowledge.
This is ancient
nothing
knowledge.
New.
Yeah, this was taught by Yogi Bhajan, who learned it from a master in India. And then, of course, we have the chakra system, the energetic chakra system. So how connected we are is how healthy we are. Are we connected to our spirit? Are we connected with the soul, which is the essence of a person? It's who that person is. It's not who we are. It's not our professions. It's not what we look at. It's not how expensive cars we have. It's none of that. It's not how much money we have. It's the vibration that, for example, with Jan, that she has herself in her being, in her essence. So if we're connected to our essence, what happens? Our health improves. Mm-hmm. If we're not connected and we're worshiping all these things that we do, and hey, we need money, we need to have a car, we need to have a house, we need to have relationships, okay? Those are all part of life. So getting back to Jan with her,
okay? Yeah,
so
with her.
Feeling, now that we're talking, she has emotions coming up because in her throat, the throat represents the throat chakra where truth is. And she's having emotions because I'm speaking about emotions. So should we dress the emotions? Here we go. But I think before I need to do that, I need to put my hand on her because I see what's going on here. I need to release some emotional things, what's going on. Now, I've been treating her for quite a while. For at least 6 months, 7 months?
Mm-hmm.
7 months, okay? And one of her pastime phobias was she had her husband die. Okay? And she was diving into the past. She was in the past instead of moving in the future or being in the present. And when you move into the past and you're tied to someone you are mourning or you haven't released for yourself, you can't really live your life and be happy. So we released a lot of that functions. But right now, she's making a big move to go to Yucatan in Mexico. And this is moving from this country. I saw pictures. It's beautiful. Very beautiful. So let's get back to healing her. Okay. So I'm feeling her spine right now. So what I want to do is right now is I want you to bend your knee, left knee. So bring it up. And I want you to flop it out to the left. Okay. Can we bring one of those chairs over here?
Sure.
Can we do that? That'd be great, instead of kneeling.
Okay.
And so what I want to do is, I want her to, if you could bring it behind me, that'd be wonderful.
We've only got 2 minutes.
Okay. So what you want to do is, you're going to drag that left leg down to the right, Jan, and breathe, and releasing the meninges in her spine. Because what's happened is the nerves that go into the spine, go into the meninges, which protects the spine. It's a thin layer of liquid. And in the meninges, there is the dura mater, the arachnoid space, and pia mater. And these layers communicate. So we just released that, and she, her leg, her left leg relaxed just then. Okay? Okay, let's do the right side. So we have all these people watching, so they're helping. They're energetically looking at us right now. Okay, here we go. So let your right leg down. Now, she has arthritis in this hip, okay? And we've actually helped her to get more mobile, and so she can walk better, okay? So we're going to go like this, same thing, and just drag it down. You can see the difference in the leg and how it's flopping over to the left, okay? Okay, do it one more time. Do it again. Very good. Okay, good. So what's happened is your hips relaxed. So let's just get down to the sacrum. So we have, okay, so could you lay on that side? And straighten out this leg right here. And she has problems with her, this is her coccyx, okay? The camera can't see right now. And then right here is her SI joint. So what we're gonna do is she's gonna drag her foot down, and you're going to move your hip into the table. Then bring it back and do it again. Move. This is called manual therapy. This is all manual therapy. And Kate, lie on your back now. And bring this leg up. Now her sacrum is a little out. Okay, so I'm going to put my fingers under the sacrum here. I'm going to feel if it's S1, S2, S3, S4 as part of the sacrum, and it's right there. So what you want to do is, Jan, is have this leg lean against me. Bring this leg up. Bring it over this way. I'm going to connect with the ischial tuberosity right here. Press her greater trochanter, and then just slide it down. Okay, go ahead. You can bring it back up again and do it again. How much more time we have?
We will continue. We here, have got another down. Show with Jan and with with Harbhajan Singh Khalsa. Thank you, Harvey and Dottie, for operating the cameras. Thank you for George and Marshall and back. We will continue this. I'm Dr. Wendy Van Dilla with New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show.